Hello and welcome everyone to another quick edit video. As you can see, I'm working on a night shot this time, and for this image I hope I can bring back some of the shadows here, which are kind of underexposed. But I hope the high dynamic range of my DSLR will help me fix this problem. So before we start the real editing, I'm activating the remove chromatic aberration and enable profile correction settings. First, I want to give my image kind of a colder look, therefore I'm going to reduce the temperature. Also, I want to reduce the highlights, especially of the car lights in the foreground. And now I try to gain some more information in the darker parts of the image, so I'm going to increase the shadows to 100. And as you can see, this already did work quite well. I'm trying the same thing with the blacks. And I also want to add a bit of clarity. Now the blue color tones do look kind of oversaturated, so I'm going to reduce the saturation here. And I'm also going to decrease the saturation of the green color tones. Now in the split toning section, I want to give my highlights a warmer color, so I'm going to choose something between red and orange. And I'm doing the same thing for the shadows, I also want something a bit warmer. And now I want to sharpen the image. Also, if you want to get more detail while sharpening, I suggest to reduce the radius and pump up the detail a lot. Also, as you can see in the preview image, there's quite a lot of noise going on, so I'm going to add a bit of noise reduction. Also, I think I want to add a bit of vibrance to bring out the colors more. And the last thing I want to do in Lightroom is add a light leak effect, and therefore I'm going to apply a radial filter on the brighter parts of the sky. Here I'm just increasing the exposure a bit, and then I'm decreasing the clarity to give it a kind of glow effect. Also, I'm adding a bit of whites. And then I'm just duplicating the radial filter and I'm dragging over to the other bright parts in the sky. Now I have the same shot with a different amount of car lights. And I want to blend in all the car lights into one image. So I'm going to copy all those settings and just apply them on the previous two shots. This means I'm finished with the Lightroom editing and now I can switch over to Photoshop. So here I have my main image and I just drag my second picture over it. And then I'm just changing the blending mode to lighten. And as you can see, the light streaks of the cars just get added to my main picture. You may notice the sky is also changing due to the image above. So I'm just going to apply a black layer mask on this layer. And I just paint in the light streaks of the cars with a white brush. Alright, this looks much better. So I am just merging those two layers by selecting them and pressing Ctrl E. Now, first of all, I want to get rid of the grass on the right bottom corner. Therefore, I'm just using the healing brush tool. And I also want to get rid of the tree branches in the sky. Again, I'm using the healing brush tool for this. And for this big branch here, I'm just going to use the clone stamp tool. Now I want to check out some filters of the Nik collection. The first one I want to add is the polarization filter, just to give my colors in the foreground a bit more saturation. As you can see, the sky kind of looks weird now, so I'm again using a layer mask. And fill it with a black color and just brush in the lights with a white brush. And I'm also applying this effect on some parts of the trees in the background. Now I want to add a bit of contrast to the sky part of my image, so I'm going with the Pro contrast filter of the ColorFX Pro, and I'm just applying some dynamic contrast. What I want to do now is to apply a stronger light leak effect. Therefore, I first need to choose a color of the sky area where I want to apply this light leak effect. And then I'm creating a new layer and I'm choosing the brush tool with a rather large brush size and also 0% hardness. And then I just use the brush once. And then all I need to do is set the blending mode to soft light. And this I am going to repeat for a few other areas of the image. Okay, now I think I have to crop out a part of the lower image because this dirt looks kind of ugly. One last thing I want to add is a levels adjustment layer, and I just use it to give my image a bit more contrast. Therefore, I just drag the black slider to the right side. Alright, and this is it for this image. I hope this video was useful for you, and if you'd like to see more content like this, feel free to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.